Hello students, in our today's session, we will be learning about protein synthesis, the central dogma for protein synthesis and the process of transcription, which is covered in the chapter Molecular Basis of Inheritance. So let's get started. Students, proteins are very important biomolecules. They serve as structural components, enzymes and hormones. The cells need to synthesize new protein molecule. The process of protein synthesis includes two steps, that is transcription and translation. During this process, synthesis of complementary strand of RNA takes place. We have a concept called as central dogma for protein synthesis. Double-stranded DNA molecule gives rise to mRNA, which acts as a messenger to program the synthesis of a polypeptide chain, that is proteins. This type of unidirectional flow of information from the DNA to RNA to proteins is referred to as central dogma of molecular biology. It was postulated by F.S.C. Crick. Here, so you have your DNA molecule. There is a process called as transcription where you write the message from the DNA, you take the message from the DNA and you form your RNA, which is your messenger RNA. And then you have the process of translation where there is decoding of the message and you have the proteins that are synthesized. This is called as the central dogma of protein synthesis. Students, the present day concept of central dogma in retroviruses and riboviruses is given by Timin and Baltimore in 1970. Their discovery was the process of reverse transcription, using reverse transcriptase as the enzyme. So the central dogma that is there, DNA, from your DNA you have through transcription an RNA, and from the RNA to the process of translation we have proteins. But here we have a discovery of the process called as reverse transcription, where from the RNA you can get back your DNA. So when you talk about your central dogma of molecular biology, you talk about DNA. So DNA is a self-replicating molecule. So DNA on replications, you can get duplicate DNAs. Then you have the information that is passed on in the process of transcription. You have RNA that is synthesized. This red color segment is your RNA, mRNA. So once the mRNA is ready, this stage happens in the nucleus of your cell. This mRNA moves out into the cytoplasm of your cell and with the help of the ribosomes bring about the process of translation, that is synthesis of proteins. Students, in this video lecture, we will see the first step in your protein synthesis, that is the process of transcription. During transcription, information of only one strand of the DNA is copied into RNA. This strand of the DNA acts as a template. Enzyme RNA polymerase catalyzes the formation of the RNA transcript. DNA transcription takes place in the nucleus in the eukaryotes, whereas translation occurs in the cytoplasm. DNA transfers information to mRNA, which then moves to the ribosome. Students, transcription occurs in the nucleus during G1 and G2 phase of the cell cycle. The process of transcription in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes involve three stages, which are initiation, elongation and termination. You have put up an image of the nucleus of a cell. The entire cell is put up, eukaryotic cell, and this is specifically the nucleus where you will see that the DNA via the process of transcription helps in the formation of an mRNA. This mRNA moves out into the cytoplasm and it, with the help of the ribosomes, it will be used for the synthesis of proteins. So now in this step of transcription, we are further going to see what are the three steps, that is initiation, elongation and termination. Students, for the process of transcription, you require a transcription unit. Each transcribed segment of the DNA is called as a transcription unit. It consists of a promoter region, the structural gene and a terminator. So this is a promoter region, you have your structural gene and this is a terminator region. The promoter is located towards 5' end of the structural gene, that is upstream. So here you have the promoter located at the 5' end upstream. It is a DNA sequence that provides binding site for enzyme RNA polymerase. So here you have the promoter region is basically a sequence of your DNA which allows the binding of your RNA polymerase. In prokaryotes, the enzyme recognizes the promoter region by its sigma factor subunits. Then we move to the structural genes. Two strands of the DNA have opposite polarities. DNA-dependent RNA polymerases catalyzes polymerization in 5'-3' direction. So you have your opposite polarities of the strand and you have your RNA polymerase which catalyzes the polymerization in 5'-3' direction. So the DNA strand having 3'-5' polarity acts as a template strand. The other strand of the DNA having 5'-3' polarity is the complementary to the template strand. The sequence of the bases in this strand is same as that in the RNA, where thymine is replaced by uracil. It is actually the coding strand. The information on this strand is copied on the mRNA. It is called as the sense strand. The terminator is located at the 3' end of the coding strand, that is downstream. It refers to the or defines the end of the transcription process. Students, have a look at this figure here. You can see in the 3'-5' direction, that is your antisense strand, it acts as a template strand. And your sense strand in the 5'-3' direction, this is your coding strand. So the RNA polymerase binds to the promoter region and the process of transcription takes place in 5'-3' direction. So these, you have complementary nucleotides to your antisense strands coming. And basically, the information of this strand has been copied. In this case, only your thymine is replaced by uracil. As thymine is never present in the RNA, in place of thymine, you have uracil. So, this strand is getting copied in the process of transcription. Students, so now let's see the process of transcription. So, after the promoter binds to the RNA polymerase binds to the promoter region, the RNA polymerase moves along the DNA, causes the unwinding of the DNA duplex into two chains in the region of that genes. Now, only one strand, as we've discussed, acts as your template strand, and the other strand is complementary, which is actually the coding strand. The ribonucleotide triphosphates joined to the bases of this DNA template strand. As the transcription proceeds, a hybrid DNA-RNA molecule dissociates and makes mRNA molecule free. So here you have the process starting and then you have this as your template strand where the mRNA is being synthesized. If you see, there is unwinding taking place and as this is the initiation step. So after the initiation has occurred, we move to the elongation step, the unwinding proceeds and you have a complex of the RNA DNA hybrid being formed and the mature RNA, that is the transcribed RNA, it's called a transcribed RNA, is slowly being released out as the process of transcription is progressing. So this is your elongation step. Now when the RNA polymerase reaches the terminator region on the DNA, it leaves the DNA and fully formed mRNA, that is your primary transcript, is released. Can you see here? The RNA is released now from here. As the mRNA grows, the transcribed region of the DNA molecule again becomes spirally coiled. So here, where the transcribed region, it has moved ahead, this region gets spirally coiled again, forming the double helix. And you have your primary transcript being released out. So this is your basic process. I'll give you a quick recap. In your initiation step, a promoter binds to your the promoter region, your RNA polymerase, that is the enzyme required for this process, binds to the promoter region. Then that's the initiation stage. Then the elongation stage, it moves along your template strand and brings about the required complementary nucleotides and the mRNA strand is synthesized till and in the termination stage where your RNA polymerase reaches the terminator region that marks the end of the RNA synthesis and the RNA is released out and the DNA coils back again. Students, you can have a look at these pictures here again. I've put it into a picture form, the entire process of transcriptions. First is your initiation stage, where at the promoter region, your RNA polymerase binds and starts the process. And the elongation is, it moves along the DNA and transcribes RNA using one of, only one of the strands. So one is your coding strand and one is your template strand. And termination is that stage where the entire process of mRNA formation is completed. It reaches a sequence where further the RNA transcript is set free and RNA polymerase does not move ahead of that site. So here what happens is I've put another picture. So this is your entire DNA molecule. You have different genes that are there. Now you, for example, you take this gene 1. It is taken here and magnified here. So this is your DNA that we are looking at. So this is the 3-5 direction and 5-3 direction. So here you will have the promoter region where your RNA polymerase is going to come and bind, and it will use this strand as the template strand. So whatever nucleotides are present here, complementary nucleotides to that are going to come to form your mRNA. So this would be your formed mRNA. If you have a closer look at the nucleotide sequence, it is just the same as that of your coding strand. Just that the thymine is replaced by uracil. So that's why this is your coding strand and this is your template strand. This mRNA that is formed will further go for the process of translation, that is the synthesis of proteins. Transcription unit and the gene. The DNA sequence coding for the mRNA or the tRNA or rRNA is defined as a gene. Cistron is a segment of DNA coding for a polypeptide. So if you have a long DNA, one region which codes for the synthesis of a particular protein, that region is called as a cistron. A single gene in a transcription unit is said to be monocistronic, whereas a long segment of DNA having set of various structural genes in one transcription unit is referred to as polycistronic. So you have one transcription unit. If you have just one structural gene, then it is said to be monocistronic. If you have a long DNA chain and you have more than one gene, that is structural genes are present, like in this case I have three structural genes that are present, such a DNA is said to be polycistronic. Structural genes in eukaryotes have interrupted non-coding sequences, which are called as intron. The coding sequence or express sequences are defined as exons, and only exons appear in the processed mRNA in eukaryotes. So when the primary mRNA is formed, it has two regions. One is the exons and introns. So it has to undergo further processing to give you your mature mRNA. Students, so let's quickly have a look at the processing of your RNA. In eukaryotes, forms of RNA transcribed from DNA are called as primary transcripts. Such transcripts undergo changes called as processing or maturation before they become functional. So they have both, they contain both the regions which are called as exons and introns. During processing, only introns are removed by a process called as splicing. Have a look at the figure here. You will see this is your immature RNA. It has exons and introns region. Exons are the ones which have the transcribed DNA. So there is a process called as splicing, where these introns are cut out and only the exons are kept. So when you have the exons that are kept, before that you have a step called as addition of a cap, which is called as methylated guanosine triphosphate is added at the 5' end, and a tailing process takes place, which is called as polyadenylation, which is addition of a poly A tail at the 3' end. The spliced DNA is joined by DNA ligase and it is transported out of the nucleus.